This video is going to be about finding the vertex of quadratic functions. So just so you understand what we're looking for, here's a rough graph of a quadratic function. I've got a horizontal axis and a vertical axis. And I've got this point down here where the line changes direction. It had been going downwards and now it's going up. And that point is the vertex. And what we want to do is know what the coordinates for that point are. And we want to do this without graphing this on your calculator. Your calculator will tell you that, but we want to find out how to do it algebraically. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to use, let's say we have the equation y equals x squared plus 6x minus 3. Now, there's a nice way to find the vertex for this. You remember the quadratic formula, x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac over 2a. You've probably been exposed to that somewhere along the line. Well, we're going to not worry about that radical part, and we're just going to look at the negative b over 2a. X equals negative b over 2a is the formula for finding the x value of the vertex. So let's just write that over here on the side. Actually, I'll write it right here. X equals negative b over 2a. So if I want to find the x coordinate for the vertex of this equation, I'm going to take my b value. So let's see, the b is the coefficient of the x, so that's just a 6, and put that over 2a, or I'm sorry, that should be negative 6, put that over 2a. Well, a is the coefficient of x squared, and since I don't see one here, the coefficient is 1, so I want 2a, well, 2a, 2 times 1 is 2, and then I'll just take that negative 6 over 2 and reduce it to negative 3. Okay, so now I know that my x-coordinate is negative 3. So I'm going to have an ordered pair that begins with a negative 3, and then there's going to be the y-coordinate. I don't know what the y-coordinate is. Okay, well remember, in an equation, when you're trying to find out what a y-value is, if you have the x-value, you just plug the x-value in. So I've got this ordered pair and I've got the x value. So let's take this negative 3 and plug it into the equation wherever I have an x. So I'm going to have x equals negative 3 squared plus 6 times negative 3 minus 3. And I'll work that out. That means negative 3 times negative 3 is 9. 6 times negative 3 is negative 18. And then I've got a negative 3. Let's see. 9 minus 18 is negative 9. Minus 3 is negative 12. So that means the y value is negative 12. And my vertex will be at negative 3 comma negative 12. Here's another example. So here I've got y equals 4x squared minus 4x minus 5. I'll write my formula to give me the x value of my coordinate pair. X equals negative b over 2a. And I'll plug my numbers in. So I want negative times the b. Well, the b is negative 4 because I've got negative 4x. Negative 4 over 2 times a. Well, a is going to be, I've got 4x squared, so a is going to be 4. And then negative times negative is positive, so that's going to be a positive 4 over 8, and that will reduce to 1/2. So the first part of my ordered pair, the x value, is going to be 1/2. Okay? Now I want to take that 1/2 and plug it in where my x's were to find out what the y is. So I'm going to find out that y equals 4 times 1/2 squared minus 4 times 1/2 minus 5. Okay, so 1/2 times 1/2 is 1/4, and 1/4 of 4 is just 1. Then I have negative 4 times 1/2. Well, that means I'm looking for 1/2 of negative 4, so I know I've got a negative. 1/2 of 4 is 2, minus 5. So I'm going to have 1 minus 2 is negative 1, minus 5 is negative 6. So that means the ordered pair for my vertex is going to be the 1/2, that was my x value, comma, negative 6. That's my y value. Okay, so as long as you follow this formula, you should be fine. Now, there's a few examples I want to show you where things are much easier than this even. Let's say I've got an equation without a b value. I've got y equals 2x squared plus 3. So I'm going to change that to y equals 2x squared plus 0x plus 3. And now if I go to plug this into my formula for the x part of the vertex, I'm going to have x equals negative b over 2a. So let's do the denominator part first. Well, so that's going to be the 2x squared means that my a is 2. 2 times 2 is 4. But my b is 0. As soon as I see this, I know my fraction equals 0. So the x value for my ordered pair is 0. So my ordered pair is going to be 0, comma, and then whatever y is. So let's think about this. If I have an equation, if I have a graph, and I know the x value for something is 0, that means I'm on this vertical axis. So I know that my vertex is going to be on the vertical axis. But remember, from the standard formula, I know that the constant at the end of the equation, like this 3, is the vertical intercept. So that means I also know the graph goes through the vertical axis at 3. When y equals 3. So that means that my ordered pair must be 0, comma, 3. That's going to be both the y-intercept and the vertex. Okay? So if you've got an equation without a b value, all you have to do is realize that your ordered pair is going to be the location for your vertex is going to be at the ordered pair 0, comma, and then whatever the constant at the end of the equation is, whatever the vertical intercept is. Even easier than that would be if you didn't have anything but your x squared, like y equals 2x squared. Well, that's going to be y equals 2x squared plus 0x plus 0. So I know that the x part of my ordered pair is going to be 0. I know the y part of my ordered pair is going to be 0. So this parabola is going to have a vertex at 0, 0. Okay? Think about that a little bit. Make sure it makes sense to you. I guess that's about it for this video. Take care. I'll see you next time.